Hey there, how y'all doing? This is Weapons Tech Matt coming to you from deep in the heart of Texas. And tonight I'm gonna kind of switch up from my usual automatic pistol, that sort of thing, and we'll go to a wheel gun. Tonight I got this little Smith & Wesson J-frame. That's a 642 ultralight. So let's verify she's all empty. She is. Now, this little guy is 38 special. It is plus P rated. Five shot, stub nosed revolver. And it's real light. You can just put this in your front pocket pretty simply. And there are various concealed, deep concealed holsters that this thing will work with. It has this little grip here, but the little grip is pretty darn good. So let's kind of take a look at this thing. It's just a simple little wheel gun. Nothing spectacular about the sights. It's just milled right into the thing. Fixed sights, you're not gonna change nothing there. Five shots. Revolver. And there you have your cylinder release. Pretty simple. The grip is kind of a rubber urethane plastic. They're not plugged into kind of rubbery grip. And it feels real good, even though your little pinky is kind of wrapping around. The way they've done this is it still feels pretty darn good. Now, this thing shoots amazingly well for being such a little guy and with the little tiny barrel there. So what I wanted to do is just a quick review on this guy. I've taken it out and shot it, and it shoots real well. I don't believe I got a video to go with this, with that, but I will do a little review and get this out on there, and maybe I can fit in a run to the range, pending. I've got a guy that's beating down my door to buy this thing, and so I don't know right now. For me, it's just kind of been sitting in the safe. I really don't carry revolvers that much, especially these little five shots for my everyday carry. I'm typically, you know, carrying a Glock or a Kimber. But, you know, if you want a backup, a second carry, a deep backup, you know, these are the deal. When I was a police officer, I had me a Charger Arms ultralight. Well, it wasn't ultralight back then, but it was a good deep carry. I also had a Model 36, which I'd love to get another Model 36. Of course, this has the shrouded hammer. The hammer is inside. You don't have any access to it unless you take the covers off right there. But they do have another one. I think it's 643, where it has a bobbed off hammer that you can actually cock back. I'm kind of used to having some kind of hammer. So yes, that's good for throwing in your pocket. It's not going to, you know, the hammer's not going to grab anything, but I still like having that single action thing going there. So maybe that's why I'm inclined to listen to various offers. If they don't meet my price, well, then I'm fine. I'm not going to sell it. I'm not desperate or anything like that. It's a fine weapon. And of course, it's Smith & Wesson. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of give you a nuts and bolts breakdown of this guy. If you ever get a chance to pick one up, you know, maybe give you a little idea of size and what it looks like. I definitely, if I were you, before you go, if you buy guns online, find somewhere that you can go physically handle it, whether it's a sporting goods place, pawn shop, whatever, and pick it up, feel it, and see what it's like. But let's go to that end. All right, so here we have Smith & Wesson 642. Of course, it's the 38 caliber Smith & Wesson, and it can handle a plus P, has a capacity of 5. Of course, this is a aluminum stainless steel setup here. Total overall length is 6.3 inches. It does have an internal safety lock. Of course, I've talked about the sights, them being fixed, integral. It is a double action revolver only. The grips are synthetic rubber type of grip. Cylinder is stainless steel, the barrel is stainless steel, and the frame is an aluminum alloy. So you kind of see the difference between the cylinder. See if I can give you a little different. the aluminum's definitely, I guess you could say, just a little bit duller. I don't know. There, you kind of see it better that direction. But barrel length is 1.875 inches, so it's less than 2 inches long. Weight is 14 ounces empty, and it is compliant in California and Massachusetts. So those of you that live in California, Massachusetts, well, there you go. Maybe that's an option. Of course, the product feature of this guy is its lightweight alloy frame for very easy carry. Stainless steel barrel and cylinder, snag-free enclosed hammer. So see that? Totally enclosed. You're not going to be snagging that hammer. Rated for continuous plus P use. Of course, this is a J frame, and they've been making J frames for, oh gosh, I guess almost 70 years now. Of course, the police officers and law enforcement have used the J frame for a long time. Now, Smith & Wesson also has a lifetime warranty on this guy. And that kind of gives you a good view of it on that side. Let's take a look on this side. Get you up and close. This is the air weight. Beautiful little revolver, good shooter. Now let's kind of compare it to some of the other, oh, I guess you could say compact carry guns. We'll compare it to, I guess you could say, its cousin, Smith & Wesson Shield. Now, this is a Shield Plus. And you can see it's a bit littler. Obviously, this thing can just be plopped right in your pocket real easy-like. Whereas the Shield's a bit too big for that. Okay, let's compare it with another carry that is this Kimber Micro ESV. Now, they're pretty comparable in size, but the Kimber is a lot heavier than that Airweight J-frame. So that'll kind of give you a comparison between those. Now, of course, the Kimber is a 9mm, and it'll carry 7 plus 1 or 8 plus 1, depending on what you got on there. And, of course, it's just a 5-shot. Okay, so we can also compare it with the SIG. Now, this is my carry today. I've been out and about, so she's all ready to go. But this little SIG P238. Now, the P238 I can just plunk in my pocket as well. But it's a bit heavier, I will say that. But you can see size comparable. Very comparable size to the SIG right there. It's got a little more drooping down there off the grip. A little bit longer that way. But, so let's go ahead and put this back over here. And we'll kind of look down on this guy again. Again, this is a fun gun to shoot. The recoil is not that bad, even when you're shooting plus P rounds. And it's just the ease of putting it in a pocket or whatever. Okay, so what's my feelings on this guy? It's a great revolver. I mean, the trigger pull, like I said, we verified nothing's in there. Trigger pull, not too bad. I mean, it's right about, you know, I'd say about 7 pounds, which is probably a good thing if you're going to have this as a pocket gun, but it's pretty much a straight pull right through. Pull through and just hit a little bit of a wall. It's not distracting. Some double action revolvers get a bit distracting. So this has not a bad trigger pull. Unfortunately, I don't think I'm going to be able to show you me shooting this thing, because typically I'll always put in a little clip of me shooting whatever gun I'm reviewing, because this guy is just driving me nuts to buy this thing from me. So if I publish this video and there's no shooting, then you know I probably sold this guy. I sold this gun. If I've had some time to do a video shooting it, I'll include that in there, and you'll know I probably either held on to it for a bit or decided not to sell it. Because, you know, if a guy doesn't meet my price, I ain't gonna sell it. Now, if you ever get a chance to pick one of these up, I'd say go ahead and do it. It's a good pistol, especially if you're into revolvers. And it's a good option for concealed carry. And I know some people get a little worried because it's only, you know, 5-shot capacity. And then, you know, you got the speed loaders, whatever. I guess you can just have to make that choice on your own, whether 5 shots is enough. If you kind of look at the statistics of shootings of concealed carry holders or EDC carry holders, more than 5 shots is unusual. But I always like to have, you know, something that'll carry a lot more than that. But, hey, 5 shots probably ought to do the job, especially if you're a good shot with a plus P round. You can knock them right on down. And I think Buffalo Boar's got some damn good plus P rounds for this thing. But that's kind of veering off into different directions. And anyway, if you get a chance to buy one and you're into revolvers, you need something to drop into your pocket, or, you know, having your glove box and you want to drop in a pocket when you're running into the store or whatever, this might be the gun for you. Would I recommend you to buy it? Well, that's kind of up to you. Do I think it's a quality, good gun? You damn right. It's a Smith. It's a quality gun. It shoots good. It's accurate. It's light. The recoil is not too bad. And so, you know, go for it. So this is Weapons Tech Mac coming to you from deep in the heart of Texas. As always, God bless Texas. God bless the United States. And long live the Republic.